Hi guys, welcome to all of you who are watching this Instagram live. We have Ms. Darshana Asanas with us, who is the head coach for the Rebels FC women's team. A huge welcome to you, Darshana, for speaking to us. I believe you are in Bangalore, right?
No, I've come
are
back you? Home. I'm in Pune now.
Okay, great. So let's not waste any time. I'll jump right into the questions. So we all know that you've been associated with Rebels FC for quite some time now. Could you tell us about how that journey started?
Yes, so I had heard that they are starting the first ever women's residential academy, and I was really looking forward to it. And luckily, through some mutual contacts, I was able to give an interview for them. More than the interview, the conversations that I had with the CEO, with the technical director and the team, it was quite interesting. And luckily, it just clicked. These conversations just clicked for me in terms of the goals and the roadmap that they have set for the women players. So those were quite interesting, and that is what pulled me for this job.
So, we know that Rebels FC finished 7th in the KWL this season.
Yeah.
So it was a very young team, I believe. I saw a few of their matches. It was a very young team, and the girls, of course, showed glimpses of what they can do in the future. So, what are the areas?
Sorry, I couldn't hear the second part. Can you repeat?
Yeah, sure. So, the area that you think you can improve on with the current group of players?
Yes, what you started with was exactly what the scenario was. We had a young bunch of players who were pretty new to professional side of football. But we are hoping to work with the same girls and get a better rank. Hopefully even come, you know, get top two positions this coming season with higher improvement in terms of technical and tactical aspects.
Yeah, fair enough. So, the Rebels Residential Academy that is in Yelahanka, if I'm not wrong,
yes.
Is a state-of-the-art facility for the girls.
Right.
So, could you tell us a little bit more about how the student athletes have been sort of developed, their skills have been developed over the past few months, and they've been brought into the first team? How has that helped?
So, basically, when we started this plan of Residential Academy with our CEO, it was with a plan of forming like an atmosphere, designing a lifestyle, especially for women football players, where they get to learn, they get to watch their own videos, they get recovery time, they get rehab facilities, as well as balance in terms of curriculum. So we give them time to go to college or attend online sessions in the latest case. And also they get their enough time to mix up with their own team members who they are playing with. So there is a lot of off-field bonding that happens at the academy itself.
Yeah, of course. So you have the distinction of winning the sub-junior Maharashtra state championships
yes.
with Pune. That was under the VIFA. So when was this?
It was last year in March.
Okay, great. So, considering that, what are the main points of difference between coaching, say, a state team where all the players speak the same language, they have been playing together from the junior levels possibly, and a professional club side? What are the main differences that you have to keep in mind as a coach?
So, basically, when we are not a club, we are an academy. So, when we are planning something for the players in RFC, it is in terms with development of overall of the team as well as individual players, whereas that doesn't happen in district team or the state team, because we get a limited span of time where we want to perform, take the team, travel with the team, get them ready and get good results. That is not the case in Rebels. We make sure that we are developing each and every player, giving them enough time, game time, their own space to grow as players. So working individually as well as on a team base is more when we have to work with the academy. Districts is just a month or max two.
Yeah. So you have played in the IWL yourself for FC Pune
yes.
City, right? So how do you feel the tournament has progressed over the past few seasons since the time that you played
it? When I played, it was the first edition and there were few teams. I remember there was a post that was coming around Facebook that time that AIFF is approaching teams to come and play. Whereas now you see in India, each state, in the each district, small towns, they have clubs who are coming up just to play IWL. And that is, you know, I think it's amazing with this coming years. We've got so many teams who are playing IWL, which is counterparting the main problem in India, game time. So now female players are getting more matches to play. They're getting more time. More than any coach or mentor, the game itself teaches players a lot. So that's the reason you can see change in standards of women's performance now in India. They're getting more time to play. Their talent is coming out there. More rounds are there in these IWL. So it's great. I think this is what was lacking.
So Rebels being a team from Bangalore, I think KWL, the Karnataka Women's League, is probably the most the difficult and most roughly contested domestic female leagues in the country right now.
True.
So how do you see Rebels living up that pressure and performing in the coming years, considering the level of competition in the KWL right now?
Can you repeat? I just couldn't hear the last part.
Yeah, sure. So considering the fact that the KWL is probably the toughest women's league in the country at present, how do you see the team developing and reaching a stage where they can possibly compete for qualification for the IWL? Like the likes of Kickstart, Matri Pratishthan and the other teams, they are obviously more experienced than Rebels. But how do you see your team competing against them in the coming seasons?
So good that it's tough. That makes it more fun. And yes, next year we'll be 1 year old. So we'll have a little bit more experience about what is exactly needed at this level. Now, we played Kickstart for the first time. We played Bengaluru United and both were great teams. So we will learn and we'll come up with better plans how to counterattack their strategies and come up with better plan and hopefully beat them.
Perfect. So I recently happened to speak to Dangmi Grace from the Indian national team, of course, and I asked her this question as well. When you see players playing in the regional district leagues and the state leagues maybe, and then for the national team, the gap between IWL and the national team and the gap between the state leagues and the IWL, there's a slight sort of discrepancy there. I mean, the level that the Indian national team is playing in currently is way above the IWL, in my honest opinion at least.
Yes.
So how do you think, as a young coach who's training players on a daily basis, how do we bridge that gap?
So first of all, we all need to understand that when we are training a player, we train with an aim of sending them till India camp, at least doing that. Once our players, once we have that flow of sending players and, you know, when they are going and trying for India and then getting that knowledge coming back again, there'll be a fluidity when they come back. We'll not see that gap extremely. Now, what is the case? Our players are training and playing the local leagues, whereas Indian players are all going attending the camp. We need to reduce this gap by developing more and more players and sending them for India camp. We need to increase that flow of players being promoted to India camp, at least the state camps. Once that happens, we'll see same standards or same quality in all players. And hopefully have a schedule, like a proper schedule or a channelized program where they are upgrading in terms of level and not come reverse. Like we have nationals and then we have a local district league. It should happen gradually where they are improving, learning and going somewhere which is beyond what they were already playing.
Yeah, fair point. So you are an AFCC licensed coach, I believe. So where do you see yourself in the next few years? Do you have ambitions to further expand your knowledge base, take further certification courses and so on and so forth?
Yes, I want to upgrade, but I want to work more. I think by working, by coaching different teams under different circumstances, I will learn more. For now, I want to learn more, work on my errors, get to know the latest trends, And yes, end of the day, getting my license. Because we get to learn more from different coaches, from these instructors when we go for courses. So simultaneously do both.
Yeah. Perfect. All the best in that endeavor, of course. Also,
thank you.
The most thing that I wanted to ask you, another thing that I wanted to ask is, the Indian women's national team is currently ranked 53rd in the world, if I'm not wrong.
Yeah.
Which is way better than the men's team, who are at 105, according to the latest rankings. But the tragedy of that fact is, nobody in India pays that much heed to the women's football. I think they don't realize that our women's football team is that good, that they can compete against the likes of Uzbekistan and Belarus and Turkey and Serbia and all of those teams. So, from a social context, what do you think we need to do as a nation to support our national team and just to be aware of what they are doing on an international platform? Is it the marketing aspect of it, or is it just embedded in our psyche that we don't give the same importance to the female side?
I think I lost you in the middle. I'm so sorry because of the network. Can you repeat?
Yeah. I'm saying, Jay, the women's team is, of course, ranked 53 in the world.
Yes.
And the men's team is 105. But even then, the importance and the attention that the men's team gets is way more. It's at a completely different level compared to the women's team. I think we as Indians do not realize that our women's team is competing with the best teams in the world at this point. So is that a social thing, or is it because of the less visibility that the women's team has? Or is it because of our mentality, is what my question is.
I think India took time to adapt to accepting football in terms of cricket. So it wasn't for the men's team before what it is now. So with these coming years, we are doing great. But yes, visibility is an issue. We need to have more women matches in India where we have Indian supporters coming and watching what our women players are doing. Even when the matches are there in abroad, when our women's team are traveling and playing, I'm not sure if many Indians are aware that they have gone, they're traveling and they're playing a match. So yes, visibility is a big issue.
Yeah, that is the point.
Awareness needs to be spread more, even if the matches are not live. In terms of news and other platforms, we need to reach out more and make them realize that yes, women's team are winning. They're not only going and participating, they're winning and coming back. Our rank is getting better. So these facts needs to reach. But I think it is getting better with each year, with each season. So hopefully there'll be a time when women's football and men's football will be neck to neck.
Yeah, you can only hope for that day to come soon. Also, my last question for you, I won't take much of your time. My last question is, how important do you think is extending the women's season? I mean, in terms of the time duration, how important is that they get to play more matches in a year? I think that is probably the most important thing. Would you agree?
Very important. If you're an average women player in India, and if you compress the time she's playing on field matches, she's playing only 1 month out of 12 months, an average player. So these stats just prove that she's not getting enough time to perform and even excel. By the time the league starts and she's adapting to what is happening to the opponents, to the standard of the tournament, the league is over. We will not see development with this pace. We need to introduce more matches. More matches will introduce more number of teams to come and play. Like a boys team will not feel like putting up a girls team because they will be playing only one season in a year, that like one tournament in a year. So obviously you need to introduce more tournaments, more match time. So the clubs who are owning boys team will also feel right to start a girls team. We should have a plan for the girls team. More matches will give them more time to play, and then they can really choose football over other things. For example, if you go to any good player now and ask her to choose football over something, she'll be like, why would I? Rather, I can study and get job and do that for 12 months. So if you really want Indian women players to come up and choose football, we need to introduce more tournaments, we need to have more games, we need to have a concept of home and away and not just one game, which will make sure that
That will also build a solid fan base.
For sure.
It helps. It goes a long way in doing that. Yeah. Okay, Darshana, I think it was a very interesting chat with you. Always nice to speak to anybody who's working in women's football in this country, because I think I'm probably one of the few people who thinks that the Indian women's national team is way better than the women than the men's team, at least at this point in time. And I would really like us to move a notch higher. And it would be great to see the likes of you and others like you who've been training and working with young girls in this country. Thank you so much.
Thanks for having me.
Thank you, sir. Take care. Stay safe.
Bye. Thank you.